The floor.
Magandang hapon po, Senate President. If I may proceed, Your Honor. Last Thursday, I think the parties have agreed to enter into a stipulation on a singular document, Your Honor, in connection with the subpoena duces tecum that was issued by this honorable court. And for the record, let me state it. It pertains to tax declaration number F-10002-35345 pertaining to CCT number 85716 issued by the Register of Deeds of the City of Makati. Particularly pertaining, Your Honor, to unit number 31B of the Columns Ayala Avenue, Makati City, Your Honor. And Your Honor, in the light of this stipulation with the opposing counsel, let me put it of record that the document was previously marked as our exhibit 150. Okay? And Your Honor, and I will refer to the market value and assessed value duly marked and stipulated on by the parties. The market value, Your Honor, is 1,210,000 pesos, which was encircled and marked as our exhibit 150-A. Your Honor, I will also refer to the dorsal portion of the same document, which is the assessed value in the total amount of 726,000 pesos, exhibit 150-B, marked and bracketed.
But what is the acquisition value?
Your Honor, the acquisition value is, there is no acquisition value, Your Honor.
There's no acquisition value?
Your Honor, I'm referring to the tax declaration, Your Honor.
So, precisely, there is no acquisition value?
Indicated here, no, Your Honor.
How was that acquired? Was it by donation, inheritance, or what?
Your Honor, this is by purchase, Your Honor.
By purchase? So,
yes, sir.
There is an acquisition value if you buy a property.
Yes, Your Honor.
All right. Go ahead.
In that light, Your Honor, before I further proceed, the witness who should have identified it, considering the stipulation as to the authenticity of the document and as to the competency of the witness, is Engineer Mario Badillo, the head or the city assessor of Makati, Your Honor. If allowed to testify, he should have established the accuracy of the entries of the SALN as of December 21, 2010, and likewise the assessed value and fair market value as approved and determined in the assessor's office of the city of Makati.
I think that there's no problem about that.
Yes,
is
Your
there
Honor.
From the side of the prosecution?
Yes, Your Honor.
Good afternoon, Mr. President.
Yes.
That is not exactly the stipulation that we are offering.
What the stipulation, is the stipulation?
The stipulation that we are offering is to the effect that we are not questioning the authenticity of the tax declaration, but that does not go into the accuracy of the values reflected in the SALN. That is our position, Your Honor.
So in that case, would you want us to present the witness? That statement was in connection, Your Honor, with all due respect, was for the purpose for which the witness would have been presented.
Because
and for us, if I may, it would be necessary such that at the end of the day, if we are to submit our formal offer of evidence, there is some reference point that we have to start with in connection with the submission of our evidence.
What is your pleasure? Are you... do you want to present your witness?
Your Honor, we would like to, but in the light of their request last time, to agree and stipulate on this tax declaration, and in the light of the observations of some senator judges, to expedite this, we decided to stipulate with them. I think we are in agreement on the document, right? As to the authenticity.
As to the tax declaration,
as to the tax declaration. The statement of the purpose is if he would have been placed on the stand, is the purpose, and that is for purposes of the record. Okay. Unless you want him to be presented right now, Your Honor, I will have to do that. You could stipulate that with me only for purposes of the record.
Yeah, Your Honor, may I say something? We want to spare the honorable court with all these markings and trivialities, Your Honor. We will stipulate on the tax declaration and only on the tax declaration. If it goes into the accuracy of the SALN, we are not going to stipulate on that because the assessor, Your Honor, is not the one who executed the SALN has nothing to do with the SALN of the Chief Justice. But he has got something to do with the tax declaration, for which we admit, Your Honor.
Your Honor, if I may,
yes.
I think my statement was, if the witness would have testified, that was the purpose for which it was offered. I think we are in agreement as to the authenticity of the document. And following Rule 132, Section 23, I think the entries therein are deemed as prima facie. And that is the reason why we entered into a stipulation.
Stop this argumentation. Upon. There is no stipulation so far agreed upon because your minds do not meet. The prosecution, I will agree to stipulate with you only to the extent of the authenticity of the document and as far as the figures that was entered in that document, but as far as the accuracy of that document, they do not accept that. So, since that is the situation, then you present your witness.
Thank you, Your Honor. Can we request a 1 minute break?
We'll All right, call the witness. 1 minute break.
All right.